Well, here I have my Crossfire TA2 boots. And look at these bad boys. Oh, they're so beat up. But the main thing we want to look at is the sole of these. Man, completely worn, pretty dang smooth. You can see where, like, some nail spots there, I'm guessing. Got a rock stuck right there. Can look around. It's the back is separating, so you can't wear these. Take a look at the left boot here. I mean, the top's not bad. Yeah, it's scraped up and stuff, but it's not bad. But on this side, it's right here, man. Look at that. It is worn in. Got a piece of rubber hanging out. Oh, yeah, you can kind of pull it there. So it's starting to separate. You're supposed to be able to get these cobbled. Would that be the correct word? Take them to a cobbler. The cobbler can replace the sole. I'm trying to check that out, so we're gonna see if I can find a place that wants to try to do it on this, what the cost would be, and I just think that would be an interesting video. But I'm heading up to Performance Cycle because I'm gonna go look at boots, and yeah, we're gonna take a look, see what I come up with, see what I buy. I'm gonna buy something. I mean, there is other little wear issues here in the leather, but just to have a backup here, let's say it costs $150 to get these fixed. Well, $150 is better than spending close to $500 or maybe even more with tax, depending what boots you're getting. At what point does it make sense to get these resold? And maybe even, I don't know what they have to do for that, whatever they have to do, or you just buy new ones, you know? Because I got my use out of them, obviously. I mean, look at the bottom of them. There's not much tread left. And they're well used. They're well used boots. Definitely, people have no problems going to spend 150, 200 bucks on tennis shoes, hiking shoes, $300 for hiking boots. So, I mean, this provides a purpose and it actually provides protection. I mean, it does something that could save you for, going to the hospital. So it's well worth the money spent. I don't know why people get so cheap on boots. It sounds like a lot of money, but when you factor in a lot of people go in, spend 120, 150 bucks for tennis shoes that wear out in 6 months, and so you buy a couple shoes a year, that could be 300 bucks you're spending. You're getting close to a price of these boots. Why not just buy something for riding? They last you year after year and you're good to go. Anyways, let's get up to Performance Cycle up in Denver and see what they have. I'm out here at Performance Cycle of Denver, as you can see. Awesome building. It's a big location here off of near Dry Creek Road and I-25, so south side of Denver. They have a lot of goodies, so I'm going in to buy new boots because as you saw, my boots are shot. I'm pretty much sure they're shot. Can they be resold? I don't know. That's going to be for another video. Once I hear back from a few places and see if they can resole them, I'll use them for backup boots, or maybe I'll give them to somebody that just needs some riding boots. But I'm going to go in, take a look at their selection, and see what they have, and probably get something today because I have to have riding boots. We're gonna do the whole YouTube thing. We're gonna go on in. In we go. So as you can see, it's a huge place. I'm probably gonna have to do a voiceover because music. As I said, got to do a little voiceover because of the music in Performance Cycle. You got that background ambient music going. I personally don't like in stores, but a lot of stores have that. Here we go. We're going past the helmets. As you can see, they have a huge selection of gear. Tons of various helmets. 6D. Should I get a 6D helmet? I don't know. I really like my climb helmet, but you get what should fit your head. When you go try on, whether it's boots, helmets, whatever, get what doesn't cause you pain and what fits you. So when somebody asks, hey, how about this or that, it doesn't really matter.
If that Fox helmet fits you and you like it, get it. It's what fits your head, or in my case here, going to the boots. It's what fits your feet. It's what's comfortable for you. Now, they got the three TAs. I tried these on, and yeah, you know, they just didn't really quite fit my feet, and I'll explain that here in a second. I go ahead and turn off the GoPro, and I come back and I'm shooting the boots. I've tried the Garnier 12s. I tried these on. I didn't like how they walked personally. I think they were stiff. Now the Liette, they're really stiff, but a good price. They would provide probably the best protection, but they are so stiff. I like to walk around. Here's the TAs. I've already decided I'm going to go ahead and get the twos again. I put my feet in them. It's like I'm at home, obviously, because that's what I've come from. And my foot fit the best in these over the threes. The threes were a lot tighter for the same size boot, in this case, a 10.2 or a 44 European. Here I'm kind of showing the boot. And you know, turning around so y'all can have a look at like kind of how it's made and what's on it. And now again, the Liette is really stiff, but it's so it offers the best protection. It's hard to bend it. There's the buckles. It has this back bracing unit there, so yeah, and it has this rubber pad that's really grippy, so it would be really good to grip to the bike. However, I don't like the non-soleable sole, but I tried them on, and yeah, for the price, if you're a budget person, check these out. They fit my feet, and I have a slightly wide foot. They fit good. Not as comfy as the CD, you know, two TAs, but they were good. Again, I tried on the Crossfire 3 TAs, and I put my foot in, and I could tell it was a lot narrower in the boot for the same size. And I don't want to jump up even more in a size over the twos. So, and also what I did not like about the CD is the hinge point there. I could see that breaking, and then you just have the stub sticking out. I'm just like, you know, we have rocks here in Colorado. I don't like the fact there's this like hinge type dealy bopper on the side. You know, I just couldn't. And they're slightly more, but it's not like they're like $30 more. It's not like a drastic price increase. I go ahead and show the lineup here of kind of the other boots they had in stock and offer right now. And, you know, you can just kind of take a look so you know, hey, they have these boots. Well, I just picked up the boots. I went ahead and got the Crossfire 2 TAs once again. Reason being, I tried on a bunch of the boots. Sorry for the video being a voiceover, but it is what it is. And, you know, they just fit my foot the best. And I know I can walk around with them on the trail, help out my friends that are riding and ride their bikes and, you know, hike up and down. And I can wear them all day long. I got the 10.2s, I guess they call them. European size is 44. But yeah, they fit the best. And performance cycle, I think a fair price. I don't know. I think they were like, let's see what that was. So for a price, I paid with tax. Where is it? Tax. So I paid out the door $469.65 for the boots at performance cycle. The boots themselves were $439.95. And yes, you have the good old, I guess, tax there, so that's what that it brought it up to, $469.65. So it is what it is for the cost. You know, I'm fortunate enough that most of my gear I've been lucky enough to get deals and stuff on, so paying full price for boots, not a big deal. Still buying them at performance cycle, not a big deal. I'm supporting a place that is huge, and you know, they have expenses, and they're local, and they're not a dealership. So, you know, I don't have that aspect. Some people say support your dealer. Well, I go to my dealer and they have like three pairs of boots, you know. Or the one time I went in, they had
the one in the correct size and one in the incorrect size, a mixed match, like somebody bought one of each size, probably whatever fit their foot the best, and they didn't seem to care. So you have those issues. Where here, the guy doing the boots, selling the boots, was very knowledgeable, knew everything about him, a really great attitude, a really great personality. I like that guy. God, I wish I really got his name. You know, I didn't think about it because we chatted for so long, and I was like, I got to get out of here. I got to buy these and get out. So just to let you all know, they have very good help. Let Performance Cycle know. The guy was awesome. So, you know, just ask for the guy that helped the dude with the YouTube channel, and he's the one. who helped the dude that had the GoPro on the YouTube channel? So anyways, I'm going to get going, and see you out there on the trails. Have a good one. Bye.